Hello friends, today we are going to learn about type 1 error and type 2 error. Before we know what is type 1 error and what is type 2 error, it is very necessary to know about something about hypothesis. There are basically two types of hypothesis. One is null hypothesis, and the second one is alternate hypothesis. The notification of null hypothesis is H0. Zero represent the null and H stand for hypothesis, and alternate hypothesis is represented by H1. In some of the books, the alternate hypothesis also has been notified by alternate H, capital H and small a, that is alternate hypothesis. Sometimes the question has been asked about the notification of the hypothesis in the NET examination. So null hypothesis means when we say that there is no relationship between the two variables, or we say there is no significant difference between the two variables, or we could say the mu is equals to the mean, that means the population mean is equals to the sample mean. Alternate hypothesis say that there is a relationship or mu is not equal to the mean. In further videos we will discuss these type of hypothesis in detail, but for type 1 error and type 2 error, one should know at least what is null hypothesis, what is alternate hypothesis. So today we are going to learn how to decide that type 1 error is occurring or type 2 error. So for that, I have made box in which I have taken the null hypothesis. Hypothesis could be true or hypothesis could be false. And when we decide, when we take the decision about the null hypothesis, so we decide that we should accept the null hypothesis or we should reject the null hypothesis. So there could be two condition about the hypothesis, that is it could be true or false, and the other it could be rejected or accepted. If null hypothesis is true, true means null hypothesis is appropriate, and we are rejecting the correct thing, that means we are occurring a type of error. This type of error is known as the type 1 error, or in other words we could say that false positive, because null hypothesis is true and we are rejecting it, we are committing an error, and this error is known as type 1 error, or we could say in other words false positive. If null hypothesis is false and we are rejecting, that means we are not committing any error, so it is correct inference. Or we could say true, negative, the other term used for the correct inference. Now if null hypothesis is true and we are accepting the other word which are used for accepting is fails to reject. So if we could say that accepting the null hypothesis when it is true or fails to reject the null hypothesis when it is true. When is it is true and we are accepting or fails to reject, that means we are not committing any error, so it is correct inference. And the other word which is used for correct inference is true positive. When hypothesis is true, we use the word positive. And we are rejecting, we are false, that is false positive. When it is true, that means it is positive. And we are accepting it, that means true positive. And if null hypothesis is false and we are accepting, we are committing an error, and it is known as the type 2 error. In other words, we could also say that false negative. If null hypothesis is false, it is negative, and we are accepting, that means false negative. So now we can say that if we reject the correct hypothesis or true hypothesis, that is type 1 error. If we are accepting the false hypothesis or we are fails to reject the false hypothesis, this is known as the type 2 error. I hope many questions which has been asked in NET you can solve by this small box. I hope you're gonna like the video, and if you have any comment or compliment, please comment below my video. Please subscribe my channel and like the video. Thank you so much for watching full video.